What's an arc and what's a cordial? Now, an arc, you ever hear the term when, in basketball where they make the claim that he shoots the ball behind the arc? Three, right? Right? You guys know what arc he's talking about? It's the three-point line behind the arc, right? And so literally, if you were to draw a, I don't know, attempt to draw maybe a basketball court, there, yeah, the arc welding, there is something called an arc, okay? And what you have is, you've got a basketball hoop, maybe here, okay? And if you shoot the ball behind the arc, you end up scoring 3 points, right? So the arc looks like it's a portion or part of something that's much larger, like a circle, right? That's essentially what it is, guys. An arc is a portion of the circumference of the circle, okay? Now, there's two types of arcs, guys, isn't it? There's something called arc length, where you measure the actual distance on the circle, right? Right, the distance. And there's something called the measure of the arc in terms of degrees, right? So there's arc length, and then there's the measure of the arc in terms of degrees. What we're studying is the measure of the arc in terms of degrees. Now, how does that work? We'll explain it, okay? It has to do with something called the center of the circle and the angle that's created by 2 points on the arc. A chord, Mr. Tucker mentioned it, and he asked you, do you remember what it means? Well, a chord is just a segment whose endpoints are on the what? Are on the circle, okay? Alrighty? Now, I want you to notice something. What did that chord just do? What did it do to the... It went across the circle and it created
an arc.
So chords intersect the circle at their endpoint, and it creates a portion or a piece of the circle, which is called an arc. Are you with me? So we're going to be talking about that relationship between the chord and the arc that it creates, okay? So, yeah, it maybe makes some sense, I hope. It's a lot of writing. There's a lot of information. Okay. So here's the next slide. Again, write this down quickly and quietly. And it seems like a lot. But that's okay. I'll add more info once you write it, okay? Try to explain what's going on. Okay, I've got something called arcs of a circle. But I'm talking about arcs, but then I introduce something called a central angle. And you might be thinking, why? What's the deal? What's the connection there? Well, it says that it's an angle whose vertex is the center of the circle. We all know what the center of the circle is. It's the point in the middle of the circle, right? Right? So watch what I do here. I'm going to take that center, and I'm going to construct, for sure, through that, watch. Okay, watch. I'm going to construct an angle. I'm talking about central angle, right? Can I see that angle? Hey, Sebastian, you see that angle? Yeah. So you notice that the angle, look, that angle, right, the vertex is at the center, so it's a special angle called a central angle. Are you with me? Now, pay attention. If I take this angle and I move it here, give me the approximate measure. It looks like it's 90 degrees, right? So the central angle is 90 degrees. Are you with me? Hey, 90 degrees, simple, right? Now, Maeli, if that's 90 degrees and it's the central angle, if I ask you what's the measure of the arc, I'm not talking about arc length, I'm talking about the degrees. If I ask you what was the arc measure, now watch this, remember, an arc is where you take a portion of the circumference, right? And you call it the arc. So the arc, we'll call it the green arc. I'm not going to label it yet. But what do you think the measure of that arc is in degrees?
90.
It's also 90. So that's why we have to identify the central angle. Once you know what the central angle is, if you project that angle so that it intersects the circle at 2 points, right? You have a minor arc if it's less than 180, right? 90 is less than 180, but that minor arc is the same measure as the central angle, 90 degrees. So could I essentially glue this anywhere I want? Yeah. What's that? What's the measure of the arc from here all the way around? It would be 180. It's called a semicircle. I wonder if I can move that point. Nope. Semicircle. So that would be there. And anytime you have a semicircle or an arc that's 180 or greater, you have to use 3 points to identify it. And we'll talk about that in just a second, okay? So you guys get the idea how the central angle is important? You see the connection between this measure and the measure of the arc? It's the same. Okay? Now, minor and major arcs. You've got this labeled, right? I want you to add information to it. You ready? Minor arc. Ready? The angle, watch this. We're going to call angle X. It's between, it's got to be greater than 0 degrees, but less than 180. Okay, that's the minor arc. The major arc it's greater than or equal to, and actually it's not equal to 180 because that's called a semicircle. So I'm just going to call it, it's a technical term. I'm not sure how the book states it. I'm going to go greater than 180 but less than 360. Okay, I don't remember if it's greater than or equal to. But, yeah. So that's the major and minor arc definitions, okay? I want to quickly describe to you the concept of major and minor, okay? One more concept. Are you ready? Okay, here it is. I'm going to give you a blank page. I'm going to draw my own circle. Okay, red looks fine to me, so we'll go with that. Okay. I'm going to place a point here and a point here. And I'm going to tell you that the center is here. And I'm going to draw here and here, central angle. I'm going to say that's 100 degrees. Okay? I'm going to call this A, B, C. And I'm going to ask you, what's the measure of arc AB? And again, we're talking about the angle measure. So does anybody know the angle measure of arc AB? Why? You're right. Because the central angle is 100, and the central angle is always equal to the measure of the arc. It's created by the angle, the central angle. Okay, here's my next question. How do I find the measure of arc ACB, the other side? Hey, what's the measure of one revolution around a circle, degree-wise? There it is. 360 is one complete revolution, right? That's 360. If you subtract 100 from it, you're left with 260. So ACB is 360 minus 100, which is just 260. So if this is 100 degrees and this is 260, if you add up all the pieces, don't you get 360?
Yeah.
Now, I wouldn't know. Listen, this is the weird part. Pay attention to what? I wouldn't know that I was looking for AB, arc AB and its measure, if I didn't identify it with two points. No, let me restate that. I wouldn't know that I'm looking for the measure of arc ACB the other way around unless I put a third point out here. Without this third point, how do I know which way I'm going? From A to B, am I going counterclockwise, or am I going A to B clockwise, the shorter side? So you have to have that third point to tell you that you're going around the long side. You understand what I'm saying? Here, A to B, it's the shorter distance, right? Which gives you the smaller central angle measure. But from A to B this way, it's longer in terms of distance. The central angle is much larger, so your measure is much larger, right? So you've got to have the right direction. And what tells you the direction? Well, first of all, if it's only 2 points, you assume, right, that it's the shorter distance, which is less than 180 in terms of central angle measure. If it's 3 points, it's always the distance around the circle that has the a central angle measure greater than 180. It's the longer arc. You've got to remember that, 3 points. Okay. Now, just about done, guys. I want you to add one more bit of information to your slide. The two-day lesson. The naming of the arcs, and that's what I just mentioned, okay? Major arc. So that's minor. Here's major. You ready? Oh, wrong button. Major arc. Okay, there it is, guys. Major arc is semicircles, okay? So I guess a semicircle is a major arc. Okay, that's a wrap. We'll start off with more information tomorrow. Have a good day.